Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
Janet is a beautiful lady. She's living alone in a small house in the city of Detroit. She isn't so happy with her life right now, but she was before the economic crisis. In fact, the all-city of Detroit was living peacefully and quietly before the economic crisis. Janet was born and raised in the state of Michigan. She had a very nice family. Her father was used to own a small company, but it was enough to provide all the needs of the family. When she was a kid, Janet was a very spoiled girl. Her mother used to stay with her at home all the time. The mother used to take her little girl to go shopping and pay her everything that she ever wanted. When she finished her studying in high school, it wasn't easy for Janet to leave this loving home, but she had to move to another city in order to go to college. Janet went to law school, and soon she became a lawyer. Like any other lady, Janet enjoyed her time in the college. She was spending a lot of time with her friends. She was going to parties and traveling with them in trips. In the college, she had a couple of relations, but nothing was serious at that time because all she wanted to do was go back, then is having a great time. After she got her college degree, Janet decided to move back to her city. However, that she knew that she will not live the same house again, but living in the same city was enough for her. At that time, living in Detroit was a blessing. The city was full of companies and factories and rich of opportunities for young people like Janet. It didn't take her so much time before she found a job and rent for her own apartment. She was very happy that she could pay her staff herself for the first time in her life. In the beginning, Janet was so excited about her job, but soon she realized that it was so much responsibility and pressure on her, and she used to be a spoiled girl. She was always saying to herself that someday she'll get used to it, but this day never came. Janet didn't have a lot of friends from work. In fact, she had only a friend named Sarah who went with her to the same college. The two friends were trying to have a good time together on the weekend or even traveling together in the vacations, but Janet was still missing her life without responsibilities. One day, Sarah told Janet that she would like to invite a friend to join them for a couple of drinks in the bar on the weekend. Janet didn't know that this friend was actually looking for a meeting. His name was Albert. He saw Janet once with Sarah, and since then, he was telling Sarah that he wanted to meet with her. Albert was a very successful guy. He was having a very promising career. However, he was a young man. He was a manager in one of the biggest car factories in the city. In the weekend, he came like Sarah told Janet. After a few minutes, Sarah said that she had to go because she forgot something very important and she needed to leave. Of course, Janet didn't know that this was part of the plan also. She didn't have any choice but sitting there with Albert. When she went back home that night, Janet received a call from Sarah, who finally decided to tell her the truth. Sarah told Janet that she didn't have anything to do and she left them to give them a chance to get to know each other. Janet told Sarah she liked Albert also, and she thanked her for this chance. She also told her friend that she agreed with Albert on seeing him again after he gave her a ride to her apartment. Janet and Albert became so close, they were going to the cinema together, they were spending weekends together, and they were shopping together. Before they even knew, they were in love, and Albert asked Janet to move in with him. Albert's apartment was so much bigger than Janet's, and it was in a nice neighborhood. Besides, Albert was very generous with her. He bought all the things that she wanted. Living with Albert reminded her of pace and quiet life in her parents' house, where she didn't have to take care of anything. In general, we can say that Janet was very happy when she was living with Albert. One day, Albert told her that he knew that she didn't like her job and that she'd prefer to stay home, and he can help her do what she wants. Janet didn't understand how he could help her and said, "You're right, I don't like my job. Or you can say that I don't like to work in general. I was telling myself that one day I'll get used to it, but this day never came. But I still need money, and that's why I still go to work every day." Albert said, "But if you have a husband who can take care of that, you don't need to go to work." Albert said that, and then he proposed to Janet, and she accepted. The surprise that Albert had for Janet at the time was that they'll move from this apartment to a real house, a big house, with a garden and a nice swimming pool. Janet was living her dream at that time. She was married to the guy who she loved, she didn't have to work because her husband took care of everything, and she was living in a very nice house. But one day, everything changed for Janet, Albert, and everyone else in the city of Detroit. The city had gone through a major economic and demographic decline in recent decades. The population of the city has fallen from a high of 1.8 million in 1950 to 680,000 in 2015, moving it from the top 20 U.S. cities by population for the first time since 1850. Local crime rates are among the highest in the United States, and vast areas of the city are in a state of severe urban decay. In 2013, Detroit filed the largest municipal bankruptcy case in U.S. history, which it successfully exited in 2014. Poverty, crime, shootings, drugs, and urban blight in Detroit are ongoing problems. Urban decay is the process where a city that was used to flourishing and functioning properly falls into disuse and disrepair. Common indicators of a city in urban decay are empty plots of land, abandoned and decrepit buildings, high unemployment rates, and high crime rates. Detroit fits all of these categories and is the most famous example of urban decay in the U.S. Detroit is often likened to a ghost town. Parts of the city are so abandoned they've been described as looking like farmland, urban prairie, and even complete wilderness. Janet and Albert were affected of what happened to their city. Albert lost his job and he couldn't pay for the house anymore. So they moved to a small apartment and Janet had to go back to her work again because Albert couldn't find another job. Sarah helped Janet to get back to work again, but Albert didn't like the idea of staying home. He started to drink all the time. At the same point, he started to use some drugs. Janet didn't like what he was doing, but she could understand how hard that was for him. Janet tried to talk with Albert about his situation so many times, but he never listened to her. He kept using drugs and drinking alcohol all day. One day, Janet found out that her husband was sleeping with another woman while he was high. One of her friends told her that she saw him more than one time picking women from the street and bringing them back to the apartment. When Janet went back home that day, she confronted Albert with what she heard about him. At first, he told her that her friend is a crazy woman, but there's no way that he could do that to her. But when Janet told him that her friend sent her photos of him with these other ladies, he started to cry and told her everything. In his defense, Albert told Janet that he was having a very bad time and that he loved her and that he's still in love with her, but sometimes the drugs make him do things that he regrets later. Janet understood Albert's situation, and soon she forgave him for what he had done, but she made him promise her not to do it again. Albert didn't keep his promise to Janet. He continued to drink alcohol, use drugs, and sleep with homeless women. Janet got tired of her husband's betrayals and decided to teach him a lesson. She brought home a homeless and told Albert that she'll sleep with him because she felt so bad. Only then he can understand the amount of pain that she feels every time he does that. Albert was shocked by what she told him. He said, "You lost your mind." Janet said, "You did that to me." Albert and Janet were fighting and screaming on each other, but suddenly an unexpected thing happened. The homeless that she brought home with her started to scream too, saying, "Please let me go. I want to get out of here." Janet looked at him and said, "Relax. I'll give you your money." The homeless guy said, "I don't want your money. I just want to get out of here. I know this guy. He's an evil guy and I don't want to be anywhere near him." Janet looked at Albert and said, "Wow, so you're sleeping with homeless guys also right now?" The homeless interrupted her saying, "No, he didn't sleep me. Before the crisis, he was a wealthy guy, but he was so sick. He used to give money for kicking me around. But one day he went crazy and kept kicking me until he almost took my life." The homeless said that and ran away, leaving Janet in total shock. She realized that the guy she loved and married was so much worse than the guy she was living with right now. Janet got divorced from Albert and kicked him out of the apartment. She's still living alone in the same place. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.